sometimes the road is rocky and the hills are hard to climb. And my bosom friends may forsake me, but God will fix it all right after a while. After a while it'll all be over. After a while the sun's gonna shine. After a while dark clouds will pass over. God
will... There is coming. I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I would do is forever worship you. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine. I can only imagine, yeah, I can only imagine, oh yeah, I can only imagine, I can only imagine, when all I would do is forever worship you. I can only imagine.
Sometimes I fall to my knees and pray, come Jesus, come. Let today be the day. Sometimes I feel like I'm gonna break, but I'm holding on to the hope that won't fade. Come, Jesus, come. Waiting so long for the day you return to heal every hurt and right every wrong. We need you right now. Come and turn this around. Deep down I know this world isn't home. Come, Jesus, come. come, Jesus, come. There'll be no war, and there'll be no change. When Jesus comes, let the day be the day. You come for the weak and the strong just the same, and all will believe in the power of His name. Come, Jesus, come. We've been waiting so long for the day You return to heal every heart and right every wrong. We need You right now. Come and turn this around. Deep down I know this world isn't home. Come, Jesus, come. Stand face to face. How about that? Lay it all down. 'Cause it might be today. Time is right now. And there's no need to wait. Your past will be washed. Here we go. By the rivers of grace. Oh, come, Jesus, come. We've been waiting so long for the day You return. Right or wrong, we need You right now. Come and turn this around. Deep down I know the world is Jesus, come. We've been waiting so long for the day You return to heal every hurt and right every wrong. We need You right now. Come and turn this around. Deep down I know this world isn't home. Come, Jesus, come. Jesus, come. Come, Jesus, come. Come, Jesus, come.
Don't forget Wednesday sometime to avail yourself to go to our Facebook page or Sparta Church of God Facebook page or YouTube. To Brandon's page or Sparta Church of God page. And Brother Brandon will be doing the message for Wednesday. And what messages he has been having. God has really blessed him and touched him and anointed him. Must be running out of power. I want to preach for just a few moments. I will give you rest. I will give you rest. Hebrews. I'm afraid I told you the wrong thing. Hebrews chapter 4. I'm going to read just a few more verses than usual, but these are powerful, powerful, powerful verses. Hebrews 4 and 1. Let us therefore fear, lest a promise being left of us, entering into His rest, His rest. Any of you should seem to come short of it. For unto us was the gospel preached as well as unto them. But the word preach did not profit them. Speaking about the children of Israel while they were in the wilderness. Not being mixed with faith in them that heard it. They did not have faith. Verse 3. For we which have believed. Did you catch that? We which have believed do enter into rest. As he said, I have sworn in my wrath that they shall enter into my rest, although the works were finished from the foundation of the world. And he spake in a certain place on the seventh day of this wise, and God did rest the seventh day from all his works. And in this place again, if they shall enter into my rest, seeing therefore it remaineth that some must enter therein, and they to whom it was first preached entered not in because of unbelief. The greatest sin in the church is unbelief. The greatest sin that there can be is unbelief. Not to simply take God at His word. Verse 7. Again, he limited a certain day, saying, David, today, after so long a time, as it is said, today if you will hear His voice, harden not your hearts. For if Jesus had given them rest, then would He not afterward have spoken of another day? There remaineth therefore a rest. Catch this verse, it's very important this morning, a rest to the people of God. For he that has entered into his rest, he also hath ceased from his own works as God did from his. Let us labor therefore to enter into that rest, lest any fall after the same example of unbelief. Verse 12, and we'll end there. For the word of God is quick and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to dividing asunder of soul and spirit and of the joints and marrows, and is a discerner of the thoughts and the intents of the heart. Flip over with me to Matthew. We're going to be looking on your brochures of the harmony of the Gospels. Flip with me to Matthew chapter 11, verse 28. We're going to be looking at point 71 and points 72 today, the Lord willing. Matthew 11, 28. Jesus speaking, and he says, listen to these beautiful words. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Father, fill my mouth this morning with your words. Lord, let my mouth speak forth of things that are needed, nothing more and nothing less. I pray, God, that your word go forth. I believe that it will accomplish it. It'll bring to pass what you sent it forth to do in Jesus' name. Oh, in the lovely name of Jesus, hallelujah, we thank you. Amen and amen. We lived, as many as already testified and spoken to this morning, in a troubled world. We live in a world where it seems like you can't find a moment's peace. Or if you do, somebody or something will bother that peace. That's why you need to get out on the back porch many times and leave that something in the house or somewhere else. You need to look up into the heavens and come aside and meditate upon the goodness of God. Jesus Christ speaking, he said, come unto me. Now the first part of this chapter, about verse 20, we won't read it this morning, of chapter 11 of Matthew. We read how that the Pharisees and the Sadducees had rejected him. They had saw him raise a dead young man that was headed to the cemetery. They had saw him speak the words and he had risen again. And yet they doubted and they rejected the very things of God. The whole time that he's saying, come unto me and I'll give you that rest. Come unto me and what you're searching for, you will find. But they rejected him and they repented not. Jesus spoke of them in these verses and he said it'd be easier for Sodom and Gomorrah on the day of judgment than it will for those that have rejected. this last day and hour in a troubled world that we now live in, when there is trouble on every hand. I won't even get into the details today. You know it if you listen to the news or you know about the events of the day, all the things that are taking place, all the things that are happening. Right in the midst of all those things, people are rejecting the very thing they need. The very thing that will give them peace, that passeth understanding. The very thing that will give them the rest that they need. They reject and they repent not. The sad thing, as I spoke about in Sunday, as we was talking in Sunday school class this morning, the sad thing about we love the sin or we hate the sin because we know what the end result is of sin. We know that it's destroying body and soul and will eventually lead that individual into hell when they reject Christ. They have no rest on this earth and no rest after judgment. Come unto me. Come unto him. He told them to learn of him. Flip over with me this same train of thought and in this same time period in Luke chapter 9. Verse 23, Jesus speaks words, and he says this, and he said unto them all, starting with verse 23, Luke 9, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, and take up his cross daily, and follow me. For whosoever will lose his life, for whosoever will save his life shall lose it, but whosoever shall lose his life for my sake, the same shall save it. For what is a man advantage if he gain the whole world and lose himself or be cast away? For whosoever shall be ashamed of me and my words, of him shall the Son of Man be ashamed, when he shall come in his glory and his Father's and of his holy angels. Pastor Doug, how do I daily take up the cross? How do I daily follow him? Well, Jesus speaks to us and he tells us that his yoke is easy. Taking up the cross is by us placing our faith in the finished work of what Christ there accomplished. It is known by the mark that I cannot save myself. I can't get righteous enough. I can't get holy enough. I can't do enough good works to save myself. And that sin that is before me, maybe those called in sin that has them captivated, that cannot be broken outside of Christ. You can't pick yourself up by your bootstraps. You cannot stand on your own. But when you place your faith in the finished work of what Christ there done upon the cross, he'll cleanse you, make you a new creature in Christ Jesus. He'll bring sanctification into your life. He will daily lead you and guide you and direct you. And when you start to step to the right or you start to step to the left, that Holy Spirit of God, that law of the Spirit in Romans chapter 8 and verse 2, the law of the Spirit will come into your heart and into your life and will daily lead you and guide you. To take up the cross daily and follow him is for us to keep our eyes upon Christ, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Over just a couple of chapters in Luke chapter 7, I want you to read that this morning, Luke chapter 7, verse 36. You see, true rest in him will bring true worship. When I have placed my faith, listen to me, when I have placed my faith in the cross, not in man, not in some profession that I might have made years ago, not in some church or some person, but when I have placed my faith in Christ, and I have trusted in the finished work, not the wooden beam, but I have trusted in the finished work that he accomplished on Calvary. When he reached up and he got the hand of God and he reached down and he got the hand of man and he brought us together again in him. Glory be to God. When he washed my sins away.
When I trust Him and depend upon Him in those things, then it brings true worship to my heart. I don't go around with the mully grubs all the time. I don't go around depressed about the things of this world. I know in whom I believe. I know in whom I trust. And I want to worship Him and praise Him for what He has done in my life. You see, I was raised. Hear me this morning. I was raised on Church of God pews. I cut my teeth on Church of God pews. But I needed saving as much as anybody. I was lost and undone. And outside of Jesus Christ, there was no hope for me. But thanks be to God. I can take you to the place. I can tell you the time. I know the moment when Jesus Christ, Brother Eddie, came in and He saved me. When I, by faith, accepted the finished work of the cross and the work that He did. And daily, daily, moment by moment, I trust in that. I hang on to that and I know that I know that I know my name is written there. And I know He that have begun a good work in me will perform it, will complete it, will bring it to pass. I know He didn't just save me to leave me, but I know through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. 'Tis grace that's brought me safe thus far. And grace, oh hallelujah. Brother Mark's going to lead me all the way home. So daily, day by day, moment by moment, I take that cross up. Here in chapter 7 of verse 36, I was telling you about, it says, one of the Pharisees desired Him that He would eat with him. And He went into the Pharisee's house and He sat down to meat. And behold, a woman in the city, which was a sinner, when she knew that Jesus sat at meat in the Pharisee's house, brought an alabaster box of ointment, very expensive perfume, and stood at His feet, behind Him weeping. I want you to catch this picture. Here's this woman that is standing. This is the one that she knows that can make a difference in her life. Those things that have her bound, He can set her free. Aren't you glad I serve a Lord that can set people free? I'm telling you, I'm believing with all my heart that God's going to begin in this community to set people free. I believe with all my heart, it's a big statement, but I believe it with all my heart, we're going to see people that are hung up on alcohol, we're going to see God set them free. I believe people that are hung up on drugs, I know the words you use for them. Some of them's not sweet words, but let me tell you, they're people that God is seeking after. Amen? You can hate them and despise them and push them aside and say they're no good, but I want to see this church full of them because I know a God that is able to change them. I know a God that is able to come in, Brother Gary, and make a difference in their life. Oh, hallelujah. Brother Mark, before Christ comes, I want to see an outpouring of His Spirit in this last day. I want to see souls coming and being saved and born again in the kingdom of God. I want to see your children. I want to see our loved ones that we've been praying for and trusting God and holding on to God's hand, and the devil keeps telling us they're not going to come in, their hearts are hard, and their hearts are not going to be changed. But I serve a God that is still able, oh hallelujah, to reach down and shake that sinner. I serve a God, a Holy Ghost Spirit, that is still able to draw in those that are hardened, those that have turned the gospel away, that they might hear the gospel of Jesus Christ. Here's this woman stands behind Jesus. She knows this is her hope. And she's weeping and crying. It tells us she washed His feet with her tears and did wipe them with the hairs of her head and kissed His feet and anointed them with the ointment. Now when the Pharisee, that old religious group, got involved, didn't he? Now when the Pharisee which had bidden him saw it, he spake within himself, saying, now he wasn't speaking this out loud. You ever say something with your face and you didn't speak it out? He wasn't speaking this out loud, but he says this, if, you don't ever need to let that word enter in when it comes to Jesus. You didn't hear me, did you? You don't ever need to let that word if enter in. He can and he will. He can and he will. If he were a prophet. Oh, he was not just a prophet. He was the very Lamb of God. Would have known who and what manner of woman this is that touches me, for she is a sinner. Simon says, if this man were a prophet, he would know. He did know. Jesus began to speak and he asked Simon. You can read the verses later. But he asked him, he said, Simon, I came into your house. You didn't offer me the customary, in essence is what he was saying, the customary custom of washing my feet as I came into your house. You didn't offer me that. You didn't offer me a place to sit. You didn't offer me any of these things. But this woman, since I've came in, has not ceased to wash my feet with her tears. Jesus began to tell him a story, and he says, there's a man who went out and he began to forgive his servants, and he had two debtors, one owed 100 pence and one owed 50 pence. And Jesus asked him, which man do you think has more thanksgiving in his heart? And he says, well, surely the one that owed 500 pence. Jesus said, you rightly said, this woman whose sins, well, they didn't like that. Read it. This woman whose sins have been forgiven is here worshiping me. I want to ask you something. I'm going to come right point blank to where we live. I don't expect y'all going to get as loud as me. If it did, the roof might fall in. I don't know. I don't know how many decibels it'd take. I don't expect you to worship God like I worship God. In fact, it wouldn't be true worship, would it? But I'm just going to ask you, point blank, when's the last time you come aside and really worshiped God? When's the last time you got in your quiet place? Well, Brother Doug, I don't have a quiet place. You need to make you one. You need to set about making you one. Take them clothes to Allegheny Cares. Clean out that closet. Get out on that back porch. Neighbors are around. It don't matter. They need to hear you praising and glorifying God. Get to that place and worship Him. Get along and love Him. When's the last time your heart has opened up? I looked out today as a pastor. One of the greatest rewards and blessings that I receive, it's when the Spirit of God has fallen. And I'm sitting out here and I look and I see thirsty souls. My, I feel the Holy Ghost in this house. Begin to lift those hands and worship Him. And I see souls that are going through things, circumstances, situations. And I've not seen their hands raised in a while, and I see that hand lifted up in true worship. Because when you have really entered into His rest, you'll have a heart of worship. Again, I'm not saying to worship like me. I'm not saying you have to be loud and boisterous. Let me tell you, some of the best worship I see is some of y'all's got to keep a handkerchief. I've started. Or a napkin. You about wore them out a lot of times. And you're wiping those eyes. When we truly know His rest, then we know how to worship Him. Then we know how to give Him praise, honor, and glory. I believe, Pastor David, that the revival that is going to come is going to come as we begin to praise and worship God from a true heart. Not because pastor says lift your hands, not because I say praise the Lord, but when from your heart those tears begin to flow and you begin to think about, I could be in hell today were it but for the grace of God. And you begin to think about what a merciful God I serve, what a loving God I serve. And you began to give Him all those things. Though I'm heavy laden and it seems like everything is coming against me, God, I have received Your rest. And when we enter into that worship, into that rest, we give Him true worship. I'm going to close Revelation chapter 14. Verses of Scripture you've heard many times. Jesus speaks to that woman that day, and not only with her, but to us all through the Scriptures and the epistles. He lets us know that we are saved by faith. He says, woman, thy faith has saved thee. Church, if there's anything the devil wants to do, and I'm going to hush, if there's any way he wants to get at you, he's going to come at you with doubts, fear, which leads to unbelief. Thy faith hath saved thee. Go in peace. Now, I've heard some disturbing things this week. We talked about this morning. I'm going to hush. I'm going to read these verses of Scripture. We talked about this morning in Sunday school class. My, what a Sunday school lesson this morning. We talked about in Sunday school class this morning about conspiracy theories. And they're out there. There's some that's so far out there that just about makes you laugh. But I said this, and I'm going to say it again. If we only knew, getting quiet. If we only knew just barely under the surface of our government the things that are playing out. Amen. But you see, I don't have to worry about those things. I don't have to fear. If the dollar goes down tomorrow, and it could, if they say tomorrow, what little bit of money you got back is going to have to be converted so that you only have a card or electronic money. I don't have to be fearful. I don't have to be afraid. Why? Because my Heavenly Father has brought me into His rest. And I rest secure in Him. And I have a peace that the world cannot take. Listen to these words, Revelation, I'm going to hush. And the smoke of their torment, those that don't have faith, he's talking about, those who have rejected, those that have turned aside the very Lamb of God. And the smoke of their torment ascended up forever and ever. And they have no rest, day nor night, who worship the beast in his image, and whosoever receiveth his mark, the mark of his name. No rest. You want to know why I look at this world, I'm hushing. I look at this world and I see these people that are so far out there. And they are so angry. Have you ever seen such an angry time that we live in? Do you know why it is? They have no rest. They don't have a back porch to go to or a prayer closet to go to or a church to come together and enter into the rest of God. Listen to verse 12. Here is the patience of the saints, speaking of you, child of God. Here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus Christ, of Jesus. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, Write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works do follow them. I am so thankful for the rest on this earth God gives me. Someone asked me, tomorrow, the Lord willing, time stands that long, if it don't, it'll be all right. We'll be starting our 10th week of retirement. And I love it. I have worked. If you don't believe me, after a while, I'll undo my collar and you can see the back of my neck. I know I could get that brown. Had a t-shirt on. Rest. And they say, wouldn't you love to go back to work? No, sir. I've worked harder. But there's been a peace about what I was doing. There's no peace in this earth outside of Jesus Christ. There's no peace. There's no rest outside of Him. Father, Lord, I know we live in troubled times. I look around and I see the things that are coming upon the face of the earth. You've told us these things would happen. We don't have to fear nor tremble, but we can be in your rest. That peace that passeth understanding secures our heart. Sustains us and keeps us. And as many of the songs we've sung this morning, we look and we pray, even so, Lord Jesus, come quickly. And we know that day will come. We know it will. We have that rest. We have that peace of God. Lord, I pray if there's one here this morning, one under the sound of my voice, one who will listen later, that does not have that peace of God. Let this be the day. Let this be the moment. I pray, Lord, if there's some here this morning listening, Lord, and things have them bound on this earth, has them addicted. I pray, God, let them see that you're able to give them a rest from those things. That you are able to set free and make them whole. Help them to know, Lord, that you love them with an everlasting love, and this church loves them. Lord, I pray if there's one not ready, doesn't have that perfect peace, let this be the day, let this be the moment. Heads bowed, eyes closed for just a moment. Should Jesus Christ come today, and very well He could even before we leave this house, are you prepared? Are you ready? Will you go when He comes? When He steps on the clouds of glory, the voice and the shout of the archangel and the trump of God sounds, will you rise? Or will you be left behind? Make your call and election sure this day. Don't put it off. No! Today is the day of salvation. I'm not going to wait but just a moment. The Holy Spirit speaking to your heart. Brother Doug, how do I come to know Christ? You come by faith, believing in the finished work of the cross. Believing that what He there accomplished was for you. He died for your sins. Receive that as the forgiveness of your sin. Believe in that. Repent. Ask Him to forgive you today. The Spirit of God will come into your heart and come into your life and will change you. He'll take those things away. And He'll make you a new creature in Christ Jesus.
I found out a long time ago what sin could do to my life. Then I met Jesus and He saved my soul. His precious love has made me whole. And I've got a peaceful, easy feeling. I know He won't let me down, 'cause I'm already standing on solid ground.
Yes, thank God for that solid ground.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Lost, but now I am found. I was blind, but now I see. I got a peaceful, easy feeling. And I know He won't let me down.
You know that, church.
'Cause I'm already grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. And I've got a peaceful, easy feeling. I know He won't let me down, 'cause I'm already standing on solid ground. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we know less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. And I've got a peaceful, easy feeling. I know He won't let me down, 'cause I'm got a peaceful, easy feeling. And I know He won't let me down, 'cause I'm already standing. Yes, I'm already standing on solid ground.
to die for me. Arms spread wide for the whole wide world. His arms spread wide where mine should be. Jesus changed my destiny. Thank you, God, for red letters in the ground.
Thank you, Jesus.